to the Townsend Junior High Follow Your Dreams Virtual Talent Show. I'm Haley Murray, your 2020-2021 ASB Spirit Commissioner, and I'm so excited to kick off this showcase with all the talented students we have at Townsend Junior High.
Hi, I'm Stanley Alba, your ASB 2020-2021 Secretary. Rangers have discovered that while transferring safely at home, they can explore lots of different hobbies and maybe even learn they have a talent they never knew about before.
I'm Lucy Lander, your 2020-2021 ASB Community Commissioner. Still other Rangers have been practicing their skill for many years, and it shows.
I'm Dimitri Cummins-Hollifield, one of your 2020-2021 Superintendent's Advisory Council representatives. Today, we are proud to share with you our talented Townsend students playing instruments, singing, and dancing. There's even a little comedy thrown in there as well.
I'm Ella Davies, your 2020-21 Renaissance Commissioner. Now it's time to sit back, relax, while sheltering safely at home, and enjoy the very talented students of Townsend Junior High School.
Jacob Pan is an 8th grader student at Townsend who started learning piano when he was 3 years old and has been taking it seriously for about 5 years. He tries to maintain a practice schedule every day. This talent means a lot to Jacob because he plans to use it in the future in the church. And now, Jacob Pan playing the piano.
Simran Carr is an 8th grade student at Townsend who learned to sing from an interest in listening to music and singing along. Her singing was refined by learning Indian classical music for 7 years. She learned even more about music by participating in band at Butterfield Ranch Elementary School for 2 years. She has always loved to sing for as long as she can remember. She practices every day. Singing calms her down and is something that she can be proud of and strives to improve. And now Simran Carr shares her voice for us.
I can't seem to focus, and you don't seem to notice I'm not here. I'm just a mirror. Can't you hear me? I'm not coming home. Do you understand? I've changed my plans, and I'm in love, but not with anybody else. Just wanna get to know myself. I I know supposedly I'm lonely now. No, I'm supposed to be unhappy without someone. But aren't I someone? And I'm in love, but not with anybody here. I'll see you in a couple of years.
Lawrence Kim is a 7th grade student at Townsend. Lawrence learned the five drum dance, a Korean traditional art form where the dancer beats a set of five drums to produce versatile rhythms and body movements, 2 years ago. He started out with ballet, pop dance, and then traditional dance. He practices twice a week. This dance represents his culture and pride in his country, since it demonstrates what people in the past in his country did. Here, Lawrence Kim performs the five drum dance.
Barron is an 8th grade student who has known her talent for writing for about 2 years, but she recently discovered her talent for poetry when she found out Edgar Allan Poe was one of her ancestors. She practices writing all the time, most recently writing a 40,000 word book. Writing means everything to her because she feels that you can express a theme through every story. Writing is so powerful and creates a message that can be spread worldwide. Rachel Barron presents a poetry reading.
Put yourself in their shoes, based on Joker by Todd Phillips. You get up for work, but you stop by your therapist's office to pick up your medication. You depend on your medication to fit into society's normal and to keep your job to provide for yourself and your mother. I'm sorry, but we will no longer be open. Our business is doing so poorly, we're closing down. Your palms begin to sweat as your brain tries to comprehend this information, but you still need to move on with your day. You go to work as a clown. You enjoy your job, yet it is looked down upon by others. Your social class might be low, but your self-esteem is high. People don't respect you. Your medication fades and your mask being held over your face begins to crack. We start to see a glimpse of your true self. All of a sudden, your mask disappears into thin air, and you're fully exposed. Your disorder becomes clear to everyone. Your laugh is your cry, but no one notices the lie, and they expect you to act normal when you're not. You try and you try to accomplish your only dream in life. You find love, you find happiness, you find passion, you find enjoyment, only to realize that it was all in your head. Now you face the truth. People beat you up, they bring you down because you're a clown. Now you learn the only escape from this never-ending darkness is to embrace yourself and to own who you are, even when others can't. And those who can't will only try to hurt those who can. You think others are hurting you when they are, but you see them as your biggest enemy. You then realize you are the biggest enemy to yourself. You rip and scratch and tear the scars that have already been healed, but all you're doing is making the cut even deeper. So stop! Stop cutting yourself! Because cuts become scars, and scars don't ever go away.
Tina Zing is an 8th grade student at Townsend who has been playing piano for 9 years and is currently a CM level 9. He practices piano every day. He feels confident when he plays piano. Presenting Tina Zing on piano.
Krishma Para is an 8th grade student who has been playing drums for a year. He takes private drum classes and practices it 5 times a week. He is playing drums, guitar, and bass with his band. And now, Krishma Para on the drums.
Thank you. Hannah Vitale is a 7th grade student at Townsend who started learning cello when she was just 7 years old. She chose to play cello because she wanted to learn something unique. She practices about 4 hours a week. She loves the rich sound of cello and she wants to play in an orchestra someday soon. Next, Hannah Vitale performs on her cello.
Is an 8th grade student at Townsend who learned how to sing at a very young age. She has been singing for most of her life. She practices almost every day, and to her, singing is a way to express yourself. Now presenting vocals by Ava Gutierrez.
Hi, I'm Ava Gutierrez, and I'm going to be singing I'm Yours by Ella Henderson. Oh, wear your winter coat, the one you love to wear, so I keep feeling close to what's beyond compare. Those moments waking up, you catch me in your eyes, that beauty on my pillow that holds me in the night. And I would find my strength to untape my mouth when I used to be afraid of the words, but with you I've learned just to let it out, and now my heart is ready to burst. 'Cause I feel like I'm ready for love, and I wanna be everything and more. And I know every day you say it, but I just want you to be sure that I am yours, that I am yours. Thank you.
Zoe Hill is a 7th grade student at Townsend who learned how to play the guitar when COVID-19 started just 7 months ago. Her neighbor is a retired professional guitar player and gave her a couple of lessons, but she is mostly self-taught. She practices every day so that she can continue getting better. Playing guitar for her is a way to relax and to only think about the song. We are proud to showcase Zoe Hill on guitar.
Assistant to my dreams. I ooh. But the way I swear she's destined for the screen, closest thing to Michelle Pfeiffer that you've ever seen. No lady running down the riptide, taking away the dark side. I don't think you're laughing. I love you when you sing that song, and I can move my throat cause don't sing the words all wrong.
Armand Patel is a 7th grade student who has been playing the tabla since he was 5 years of age. The tabla is a beautiful, very old instrument invented in the 18th century. It was used for entertainment for the kings in India and is a very hard skill he was taught by his guru. The tabla is a very dear instrument to Armand, and he practices for 30 minutes to an hour daily. Now performing a piece of Indian classical music on the tabla, Armand Patel.
Namaskar, my name is Arman Patel, and today I'll be demonstrating the northern Indian instrument called the tabla. This is a classical. I'm going to be playing along to Shape of You, karaoke version, so.
Mika Obaja is an 8th grade student at Townsend who feels she has always known how to sing. But as she has gotten older, her voice has gotten much better. She practices nearly every single day. She loves to sing, and especially with her family since her brother, dad, and mom sing as well. She says that it's fun to sing things together, most especially because we can all harmonize. Now presenting Mika Obaja and her younger brother, Kai.
Side. what friends are supposed to do.
Give me my green tea in the morning. Be my sugar, honey. You're just so great. I wonder why you love me. You're so lovely. Can't complain. One day I'll give you my name if you're down. If you're down.
Isaac Alog is an 8th grade student at Townsend who has been playing drums for about 3 years, and he went to a music school to learn. He practices almost every day and he loves doing it. Presenting Isaac Alog on drums.
Claire Lee is a 7th grade student at Townsend, whose talent is playing the piano. She started learning when she was 6 to 7 years old because she thought it looked fun. She practices an hour every day and learns how to play from her piano teacher. Next up, Claire Lee on piano.
Kelsey Myers is a 7th grade student who has taken voice lessons since she was around 5 years old. She practices every day, multiple times a day. Singing means everything to her. She does it as a stress reliever and as a pastime. And now, a vocal selection by Kelsey Myers.
I'm trying to hold my breath, let it stay this way, can't let this moment end. You said I'm for dreaming me, getting loud now, can you hear it echoing? Take my hand, will you share this with me? Starting without you, all the shine of a thousand spotlights, all the stars we steal from the night sky will never be enough. Never be enough. Tell them ghosts, down too little. These hands could hold the world, but it'll never be enough. thousand spotlights. I'll shine this year from the night sky. I'll never be enough. Never be enough. Turn them gold or stand to lean on. These hands can hold the world, but it'll never be enough. Never be enough.
Darren Chen is an 8th grade student who started playing drums about 4 years after he realized playing drums took a lot of stress and pressure, so he adopted it as a major interest. And now, Darren Chen on drums.
Ayushka Chethan is a 7th grade student whose talent is baking. She is a self-taught baker and loves watching YouTube videos and Google recipes to learn. She has been baking for 2 years and loves every moment of it. She likes to bake every weekend because it means that she can explore recipes and show creativity with her decorating. And now, a little lesson in baking with Ayushka Chethan.
Decided to do baking, so I'm gonna be making a chocolate chip cookie layered with a chocolate brownie and a s'more cake recipe. Okay, so what you're gonna need is a big bowl, and then for your dry ingredients you're gonna need flour, brown sugar, baking soda, baking powder, and you're also gonna need granulated sugar and chocolate chips. So this, we're making the chocolate chips recipe first for the first layer. And for our wet ingredients, we need baking pure vanilla extract, 2 large eggs, and room temperature salted butter. First, you need to add 1.5 cups of flour and 1/4 teaspoon of baking soda, 1/2 teaspoon of baking powder. Then you just want to mix all of these together. You can use a sifter, but I'm just going to mix it. Next, you want to add your sugar and butter and whip until light and fluffy. After you mix it together, it should look like this. Then you want to add in your brown sugar too and beat that until light and fluffy.
Afterwards, it should look like this once you combine the brown sugar to the butter. Now you want to beat in both of your eggs. And we want to make sure there's no eggshells. Now you want to add in your dry ingredients and mix them thoroughly. The recipe for the brownie mix, you have to add 3/4 cup flour and 1/4 cup cocoa powder together. Then add 1 cup of sugar and 1/4 teaspoon of baking powder. Add the butter to your mixture of dry ingredients. Then add 1 egg. It should end up looking like this. Set your oven to 350 degrees and start preheating. Take it out of the oven and it should look like this. Then you want to add some marshmallows, big or small, all around and keep it in the oven for 5 minutes. And this is what it should look like.
Layla Malucky is a 7th grade student whose talent is poetry. She developed this skill because she wanted to write words, and they just came out as poetry. Her family always said she had a way with words, so now she uses her words to influence the world around her and try to share others' experiences and what they've been through. When she writes, a whole emotion just seeps into her hand and flows into words. She expresses so much in her poetry that she hopes people recognize. She believes words are in everyone, you just have to use them. Her poetry is sacred to her. And now, Layla Malucky and reading poetry.
Some days, happiness is a friend. The sun glowing and radiating the happy waves in my mind, then the sun shrouded by clouds, sadness, anger, frustration, like ink spreading through water. It strangles the feelings I have never felt. The rain pours the tears of burdens I have felt for years, tears that I've cried, crying, and never cried. Drafted petals of sorrow, turning black as it hits the marble. Roses long put at the grass, now yellow and rotten. Roses, long overdue, like me. City lights blind my eyes as I remember the life I never lived. A life where life was perfect. I was perfect until I wasn't. I've lived my life in the back seat, watching everything flash before my eyes instead of seeing it in clarity, watching a figure drive a car in my mind. I always have. The mind is a cell, concrete, where I can never escape, where I can never leave, where the dreams are made and where dreams die. In my book, sadness is ink, and I write books of my life in ink. And once the first page has ink, it bleeds through every page, a monster dripping year by year into a body that was never mine. Mine, a monster called myself, called anxiety, a monster that has torn my soul like a puzzle with 1,000 missing pieces, a mirror shattered never to be fixed. Perfection was a standard that I wanted to meet, but how can you be perfect if there is no such thing, if the fringe of life relies on the so-called perfection? Drowning in the darkness of thoughts, outstretching hands chained to the rock bottom of sorrow, nobody grabbing me, water roaring, waterfall crashing as it seals the last words I never had. But no, instead, I'm watching the sun cloud, leaves blow, hands pale, pale white, pale like the dove, the ashes of my breath blowing away. People think they understand that they've been there, but understanding me is being able to attract space, chart the universe never to happen. You see, the life I never had is a special case, a case where I can fall at the foot of a mountain to the hands of death's hands, but the life I never had, well, I had a bucket, a cornucopia of never-ending lives. Alas, that never-ending bucket is up for the life I never had. So, let the rain, let the water roar, let the angels sing, let my wings soar. Let the trees sway, let the birds sing, let the weak shelter upon my wing. And if I was ever angry or sad, I'll remember the life that wasn't that bad, for a life I never had. Here I am at the top of the mountain that meets the river that once swallowed me, watching the willow tree twirl in the wind. And here I am, angel wings and dove features, a shining glow, gluing the mirror of myself together, making the last pieces of my very own puzzle, shining a light to my darkness, singing near the river, rejoicing the rain, coloring over the ink, and driving my own mental car. And standing here with a smile, with one last petal, they love me. It could have been your life, your friend's life, a dog's life, but it was my life. A life where I smiled and cried, lived and died. But the roses are wilted and the last petal isn't fading. Wings outstretched, moon twinkling, eyes sparkling, scents of rose in the air, wind holding my hand as I fly away from the grave of the life I never had.
How Ran Jerry Jing is a 7th grade student who started playing piano when he was around 6.5 years old.
He practices almost daily most of the time for about an hour or more. It is his hobby and a skill that he has continued and not given up nurturing and improving over the years to get to the top level of playing the piano. How ran Jerry Jing on the piano?
Miley Jane Gavarette is a 7th grade student at Townsend who has been singing and doing theater since she was 6 years old. She takes voice lessons every week. Seeing people happy through her singing makes her happy. Now presenting Miley Jane Gavarette on vocals. Is an 8th grade student who can play ocarina. She learned it from school starting in the 5th grade. She usually practices it for her hobby and it helps her make her stress disappear. Ji-Yoon Selena Ru playing the ocarina.
Viviana is a 7th grade student at Townsend who has been doing ballroom dancing for about 6 years. She practices with her partner and takes less than 6 hours a week. They dance in both the Latin and ballroom dances. What she likes about ballroom dancing is the rhythmicality of the choreography. She also likes the partnership aspect of ballroom, which most other styles don't have. When she's doing ballroom, she feels like she can challenge herself more than other things she does. Now presenting Viviana dancing the cha-cha with her partner.
Dix familles, dix tiers-monde, qui dit fatigue, dit réveil, encore sur de la veille. Alors on sort pour oublier tous les problèmes. Alors on danse. Alors on danse. C'est fini, car pire que ça, ce serait la mort. Quand tu crois enfin que tu t'en sors, quand y'en a plus, eh ben y'en a encore. Et cela zig tous les problèmes ou bien la musique. Ça te prend les tripes, ça te prend la tête. Et puis tu pries pour que ça s'arrête. Mais c'est ton corps, c'est pas le ciel. Alors tu bouges plus les oreilles. Et là tu cries encore plus fort, mais ça persiste. Alors on danse. Alors on danse.
Dulce Asuguera, 8th grade student who has been playing violin for about 6 years. She and her sisters formed their own trio about 4 years ago. They love to perform in events and private functions. They practice constantly to add songs to their repertoire. Music is her passion. She loves playing various instruments in addition to the violin. Through music, she has the opportunity to perform in front of friends and family, as well as on stage in front of large crowds. Now presenting Dulce Asuguera and Sisters.
Talented students at Townsend who are willing to share their talents with us and the world in our virtual talent show.
We hope you're inspired just as much as we were to get out there and try something new.
That's right. There is no better time than now to follow your dreams and discover your greatest talents.
Thank you to the ASB officers for lending us their voices to introduce each act. We appreciate your bright leadership.
Can't wait to get back together in person. But until then, Rangers, don't forget to keep shining bright.